Why do I have GERD? Let me talk to you about heartburn. Now, a lot of people like to call it GERD, gastroesophageal reflux syndrome. It's a fancy name, but it doesn't really mean much beyond heartburn. Other than it tends to be an automatic reach for a prescription pad or an over-the-counter drug to counteract it, instead of what your grandmother would have told you if you came to her and said, "Grandma, I have heartburn." What would she have said? She would have said, "Well, what did you eat? What bothered you?" Or her next sentence might be, "Here, have some bicarbonate of soda and be careful what you eat." So I want to take it back to the pre-drug days, because the drugs actually have a lot of unpleasant side effects. Right now, the drugs called PPIs, or proton pump inhibitors, which are available over-the-counter as well as by prescription, have a warning on them that you shouldn't take them for longer than 3 months. Now, the FDA put that warning on the prescription drugs. When asked why that warning was not put on the over-the-counter, same drugs, but in slightly different doses, the FDA said, "Well, those drugs already say you shouldn't take these for longer than 2 weeks without consulting a doctor." However, in my experience, people don't follow that recommendation because there is no warning about it saying, "Hey, don't take these for longer than 3 months because they can actually cause life-threatening conditions." Yes, you got me right. These drugs can cause life-threatening conditions. So let me tell you a little about it. Stomach acid is essential for life. It sterilizes our food, and it is the first step in digestion as well. So when you don't have stomach acid available, certain things don't get absorbed, like magnesium, like calcium. Both of those are needed for bone health. Magnesium is needed to control your heart rhythm, and some people may get life-threatening abnormal rhythms in their heart. You also may be missing vitamin B12, which can cause pain when you're deficient in it, and it can also cause a brain damage that is reversible if you catch it early enough and get B12 into your system. There are other deficiencies that can be caused, and so these are drugs that you have to be really careful about, and I strongly recommend you find out, how does your body want you to eat? The other part of this is that constipation is a factor, because when things are not flowing through your gut well, your stomach has nowhere to empty its contents. So if you're constipated, things back up and they want to go back upwards. So it's much better to have regular bowel movements and then have not have heartburn. So watch what you're eating and don't get constipated. By the way, it is okay to take one of these drugs once in a while. If you're going out for a big dinner, if you're at a wedding, if you're doing something and you know you're eating food that's going to disagree with you and give you heartburn, go ahead and take one of those PPIs, but don't do it on a regular basis.